Hi friends, we know components are the basic building blocks in Angular. When we create a component, we need to declare in the module in which we are going to use that component, otherwise it will throw error. However, starting from Angular 14, we can create components that exist independently without being part of any ng module. Those components are called standalone components. In Angular 15, the standalone components become stable. Till Angular 16, while creating a component using the ng-generate-component command, we can use the flag --standalone to create a standalone component. But starting from Angular 17, if you are going to create a component using the ng-generate-component command, it will create the standalone component by default. That means we are slowly moving towards the standalone components. In future versions of Angular, I feel standalone components are going to play a vital role. In near future, if you are planning to upgrade your application from Angular 16 to 17, you should have good knowledge on standalone components, otherwise the migration is going to be a nightmare. So I believe now you would have understood the importance of learning about standalone components. In this video, I am going to explain about the need for standalone components, its advantages, the difference between the normal components and standalone components, and how we can improve the performance of our application using standalone components. Let's start. First, I want to talk about the difference between a normal component and a standalone component. I have installed Angular 16. Let me create a new application. In this application, let me create a normal component. And then, let me use the standalone flag to create a standalone component. Okay, let me open this in VS Code. We can see the normal component alone has been imported in the app module. And in the standalone component, we can see two new properties have been introduced. Standalone true. This informs Angular that this component can operate independently and does not rely on other modules or components. And using this imports array, we can import the component specific dependencies. That means this component does not require any specific module imports. Okay. Now let's try to use both of our components in our app component. As the normal component has been already declared in app module, it is fine. But as this special component has not been declared in app module, it is throwing error. Okay, how can we fix this? We should not declare this in app module. Instead, we need to import this. Now we can see the error is gone. And if we preview, we can see both the components. Let me create one more standalone component. And let me use this component in our existing standalone component. Now also it is showing error. This time, instead of importing in the app module, I can use this imports array to import. Okay, I believe you should have get some idea now. Let me install Angular 17. Now let me create a new application. We can see by default the app component has been created as standalone component. And the app module has not been created. Let me create a new component without standalone flag. We can see even the new component created is also standalone component. So in case if you have already upgraded your Angular CLI to 17 and for some reason you need to create non-standalone components, that means an application without app module, how can you do? You can use the flag --no-standalone. Now we can see the app module has been created and the app component is also not a standalone component. Fine. We understood the difference between a normal component and a standalone component in Angular. But why do we need standalone components in Angular? Does it have any advantage? Standalone components provide a simplified way to build Angular applications. It reduces the need for ng module. Modules may have unused components and services, those increase the bundle sizes. By transforming individual components into standalone components, we can eliminate the unnecessary imports and unused dependencies. Also, by isolating components into standalone modules, we achieve improved modularity, reusability, and maintainability. In my previous video, I have explained how we can use lazy loading to improve the performance of our application. And I want to say that we can lazy load the standalone components also. Let me show you. I have created this application. This is created using Angular 17. Here I have a home component, user component, and an admin component. All these are standalone components. I have also added the routes, and in app component, I have added the navigation links. So on clicking these links, we can go to various pages. Okay, let's see how we can lazy load this admin route. The syntax is almost similar to lazy loading a module. In case of module, we use load children, but here we need to use load component. Now let me refresh this and let me clear this. If I go to user route, nothing is downloaded because user is already part of main bundle. Let me go to admin route. Now you can see it will get downloaded here. That means it is getting loaded lazily. So using standalone components and lazy loading, we can improve the performance of the Angular application a lot. Hope you understood. Please like this video and subscribe to this channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.